emotionally I'm scared, you know, and I'm scared about variables that I actually have absolutely no control over. I don't know what it's going to be like to climb in the cold, and I don't know what the altitude is going to do to me.
Yeah, we're just waiting for our last flight to Kilimanjaro. We're gonna get in really late tonight. We're a little tired, but we're excited just to get to the final destination. And then, of course, get to the summit of Kilimanjaro.
Packing was stressful. That was 2 days of stress packing. You are not allowed to take a lot of stuff to Kilimanjaro, and I kept taking things out, and now I feel like I have nothing. Should be interesting what we smell like when this is all done.
And then there's the whole thing whether we forgot anything, and so extensive packing list, and I went over that probably 3 or 4 times, and but I know I've still forgot stuff, and we'll find out on the side of the mountain, but we'll pull together as a team.
Our guide, like, unpacked her big bag and put all of her stuff out. I started to get worried because I didn't have half the stuff on the list. So it was sort of beg and borrow, and I did steal the hotel towel actually to use for my face, which has been really handy so far.
I'm full of different emotions right now. I got like a little bit of fear, a little anxiety.
You only have one sleeping bag too.
Feeling great, just ready to get started and get up there.
Cool kids sit at the back, guys.
Big smile on my face, we're approaching Kilimanjaro. Finally, after months of preparation, the mountain is in sight. We're gonna be climbing it in like another hour.
Kili's been on the bucket list for a long time, so, but it's now, it's real. I mean, we're looking out the window at the kind of humbling mountain.
I'm nervous, I'm anxious, I'm nauseous because I'm so nervous about getting to the top.
I'm gonna take it one day at a time, you know, even 1 hour at a time, but goal is that we're all making it to the top.
Nerves are a little bit there, but mostly excited. I think there's also a healthy dose of fear in there.
We are right now at the base, and you can see everybody kind of having a snack before we take off, and I'm nervous. I can't wait. I don't think it's going to be amazing.
Everybody's got a really good attitude. Everybody's listening. 2 years of build up, and now it's finally here.
Okay, guys, let's go.
I don't think any of us really knew what to expect, but we finally got on the trail, and it was steep. Like, we were having to work to get up this hill.
So far so good. We're about an hour and 10, hour and 15 into this leg, but I've already sweated through my shirt.
I feel great. Just had a little pee break, first pee break. Took some water, and I'm about to eat some, thanks to Chris.
Oh, power gel.
This is gold up here, liquid gold.
The team is doing very good because since we started eating slowly, stopping the drinking, chatting, it's making the trek busy.
Trying to find the pace, you know?
Yeah.
It's like a little bit of a lower pace, but it's good. It like gets you in the groove, you know?
And it was pretty neat kind of seeing the different vegetation because we went through sort of jungle today and we saw these black and white monkeys in the trees.
Yeah.
Cheryl, how do you feel?
I feel good. The backpack's way too heavy. I brought my teacup that I get quite attached to, and I have a lot of solar stuff.
Was it made out of lead or something?
Yeah, I think it's a really heavy teacup, but I'm going to get rid of it soon.
We wandered into camp, and it's like coming into a tiny village. Like, there's all these little domes across the horizon, and you got to pick your tent, got to get your stuff inside it, lay out your mat, and then your sleeping bag, and it's pretty tight quarters because we're sharing. It's two people to a tent.
Routine here, what's going to happen when you arrive in camp pretty much most days is that you will get here, you will find your tent, you'll go in, you'll set up your camping equipment. Washing water will be coming around to your tent, so then you've got time to freshen up, get cleaned up.
It's a great feeling to be through that first part and to know that we're into our journey.
You know what, day one was fantastic. I can't, come on, bring
had
me
a great
info
time
here.
Today.
That Rick is something else. Oh, sorry guys, are you doing in the middle of something here?
This guy.
First, we have to address the costume, right? We have to address
it's not a costume, it's a way of life. I feel good now. Like, now, once we got to camp, you know, unlaced my boots a little and got into my onesie, I just feel better.
So here's what we do, Rick. We pull out the shelf, lift up the lid, sit down and do your business. We won't film that part. Apparently at altitude, stuff can fly out.
Yeah.
Now close the lid, do some pumps. Yeah, make sure, okay, yeah.
Oh, that is, I can eat my dinner off that tonight.
Bada bing, bada boom. That's how it works.
It's all yours, man. No, I gotta wash my hands.
Yeah, good call.
You're tired, you're sweaty, you need to wash, you wanna get clean. So you just quickly kind of go in, get cleaned up with, they bring water, they're amazing here. And then you change into kind of what you're gonna sleep into, got my down booties on and get ready to crash. So, and I can see some early nights.
Oh man, is it time?
6 o'clock.
6 o'clock?
It's 6 o'clock in the morning.
So we gotta get up and go.
First night in the sleeping bag on these thin mats, not the best.
Let's do it, day two, we can do this.
Let me say, I slept with my roommate, my tent mate, Alicia, and that's the closest I've been with anyone in a tent for a long time. There's an issue with peeing a lot.
We had some fun last night. We had dinner and we played some games as the group, and then we turned in fairly early. Initially slept great, but then I woke up at like 2:30 in the morning and I couldn't get back to sleep for the life of me. So that gave me some time to reconfigure my bag.
This would be Mother Nature's Stairmaster. So I'm looking forward to getting out of this part of the terrain. It's been very steep and rocky. My glutes and my knees are really feeling it. I just want to like lie down and maybe the porters might carry me.
Maybe, can I put one more down here too? As I run my finger, I feel it now a little bit here.
We're doing some preventative medicine. Rick's got a hot spot, so we don't want a blister forming.
It just started happening like 15 minutes ago. And I wanted to get through it the best I could, but, you know, just preventative. It's nothing serious.
Well, we started at
or 9,000 feet, and we're now at a little over 11,000 feet. 4 hours to get to this point, and it's been a lot more technical, through a lot of rocks and paths and tight, but the group's doing amazing. It's been great. Everybody is so, I think, positive and so excited, and that's carrying everybody through.
What's the one thing that you're, I guess, looking forward to tonight about getting to camp?
Bed. I really would like bed. You know, your feet start to get sore, it gets a little bit. Bed will feel really good tonight.
So we've ascended 750 meters already, but as you can see in the distance way over there, that's where we're going to be setting up camp. So that's a little motivation for us. We probably have another, I'd say, hour and a bit to go, depending on our speed. I better get to it.
Do today as a group.
You were amazing today. Okay. Like, yeah. I've never arrived in this camp anywhere near this time. Like, to be here at 2:20 in the afternoon is incredible. Like, I'm normally way back down there on the ridge still, so yeah, really, really impressed, really strong.
Our new camp is it's very exposed, so I'm told it's going to be a really cold night tonight. We're going to snuggle.
I'm excited that I've made it this far. Like it this is outside of my my comfort zone for sure. I'm doing this for the kids and for the people that need that assistance. So every time I slow down and I think, oh God, I just want to stop or lay down and rest, I keep going, soldier through the pain just for that reason. I think about that. So we just saw some members of the Maasai community here who have been involved with World Vision, and the women and the children are the ones that really were taking the lead here. They were starting businesses, they were learning how to enterprise and become self-sufficient. I love taking part, I like getting involved in traditions or what they're doing, and when we first came up, all the girls were dressed in these traditional headdress and they were dancing, and I'm like, I gotta try this out. They tried to fit me with some of the accessories and my head was too big. I feel like when you're back home, people think that they understand what's going on, but you don't really get it until you're there. Seeing the kids' faces really sets the tone for why we're doing what we're doing here. Like, this tells you what's on the line. Like, when I climb up Kilimanjaro, I'm not just doing it for the fun of it. I'm doing it because it's for a great cause. Like, it's creating opportunities and a new life for a lot of these people.
The summit is right over here. I'm like, now we see where we're off to. The end is near. That's so cool to see that and to know it's right there. And in a few days, we're going to be on top.
This was a big climb today. We climbed from 9,000 feet to 11,500. So long way up. We're all a little pooped. It's going to be an early one. I think I'll make it through dinner and then I will be heading to this amazing sleeping bag for bed.
Can you talk about just seeing the stars last night?
Oh, it was great that you woke me up, but yeah, thanks for waking me up. I don't know, I'm so glad you did. The stars were amazing, and they're, I think we live in the city and the lights, you never really see them like that. They were massive and so bright, and it was just the neatest thing to see without having all the city lights affecting them. So thank you for waking me up.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Hey everyone, day three on the mountain. Behind me is Kilimanjaro somewhere, if you can see it. Today's gonna be a tougher day. We're starting to go up today to about 4,500 feet and then sleep a little lower than that. So it'll be great. I'm looking forward to it and we'll talk to you tonight.
And here you can see the helipad. These are used for rescue purpose. When people get sick of like a serious one, such as
like
a,
when Rick had that little thing on his foot, that
yeah,
little hurt.
Oh yeah, that,
they
yeah.
might have helicoptered you out of here.
A serious one, like a lung just full of fluid.
Oh yes, yes.
Yeah,
it's a matter of life and death. That the time, those minutes, those precious minutes. Yeah.
Well, every so often there's been the Inukchuks, where people have like piled the rocks up. So what I would love to do is like make a giant one, like with the big boulders, pile it up like 40 meters high.
That's a good idea.
I mean, it sounds good. I won't be able to do that. But.
Yeah, just bring the backhoe. What do you got in your pocket?
I've got some garbage here.
Where do you find it?
I found it right over there under a tree. It just really upsets me.
You hiker of the day.
Anyway, you would have done the same thing.
You weren't picking up any of the used toilet paper, all right?
We've called it sending a text on Mount Kilimanjaro.
And please, guys, there for sending email and fax or attachment. Man this site.
Number one, fax. I think they're a little bit behind on their like technology stuff. I mean, it might be like Twitter and Facebook now, but anyway, a fax is number two. And you know, on a hike like this, you gotta communicate sometimes. Sometimes you gotta send out a message.
Bring it, right?
We have made it to camp today. Lots of up and down, fog and clouds everywhere. But I feel way better than I did yesterday. So pretty much I'm invincible.
The group is doing really well. Any problem? This is a very good group which I never climbed. I never had climbed with. Because other group I normally climb with at this stage of Shira, which is 3,840 meters above the sea level, you find a lot of problems such as high altitude sickness. So far, no one has any problem related with.
Hi everyone, end of day three. As you can tell, I'm looking a little tired. We climbed to Cathedral Peak today, which was 13,500 feet.
In case we don't make it, the summit!
And now we've come down and we're sleeping at about 12,700 feet. And tomorrow, I guess, day four is going to be a really tough day.
So that is Kilimanjaro.
It
Sleep like a champion?
Yeah, so pretty good. Now I'm gonna pull a Rick Campanelli and brush my teeth.
Right guys, you got 2 minutes, so you should be headed into the mess tent, please.
Yeah.
I want to shower in your hotel.
It's like we're at the fair.
Oh yeah. Oh, as soon as we get to that hotel, oh, it'll be like
the grime that will come off.
It's gonna be running dirty for a few minutes.
Today, with our journey for 4 hours, we were getting closer and closer and closer, and it was getting bigger and bigger. And this is a massive beast we're talking about here. You know, the tallest mountain in Africa.
This is a stunning topography, and it varies from zone to zone. We'll go through an area that seems like the top blew off a mountain with shrapnel everywhere, these massive boulders that must have dropped down from the sky. Then you go through an area that's just, you know, barren shrubbery. And then we get this glimpse of the mountain. The closer we get, the more majestic it is. It's just incredible. Yeah, it's amazing. We're just coming up to this lava tower, which is pretty awe-inspiring.
Lunchtime, girls. Most daunting thing is seeing Kilimanjaro, and it's getting bigger and that's getting a little bit like I can feel a little anxiety just thinking about what's to come.
The hardest part for me was we saw the in memoriam plaque, and that was huge for me. It was a former climber, leader I believe, who came up here and unfortunately was struck by lightning. But what really struck me was below his name you saw the words attitude before altitude. And that was kind of the kick in the behind that I needed, I think. So my success for today is totally going to be owed to him and seeing that, because that was kind of, that was the moment I needed, I guess.
Yeah, it's a pretty surreal setting where we're in right now. You've got this glacier-fed stream feeding down the middle of the valley. You've got what looks like palm trees on either side of this river.
We did some acclimatization yesterday, which was fun, but it's still a big mountain to climb. And you can definitely feel the altitude. You can definitely feel the lessening of the breath. Amazing views, it's unbelievable. And just the different landscapes that we've come through, from scrub to alpine meadow to now just barren rock. So it's been quite a journey already.
We've been gradually moving up, but now we're seeing what we've got to do and what's to come. I can feel it everywhere. I can feel my eyes swollen, my lips swollen.
It's been a tough morning. It really has been. You really start to feel the elevation increase, because right now I believe we're at 4,600 meters above sea level.
Dying grass and falling autumn leaves. Christmas trees. What a funny kind of way for two people to meet.
You're gonna fall off and break again.
I know. I think that's what I'm taking them up on.
I want to put something
well,
up.
The times are changing.
Bitterly cold morning. My coldest, I think the team's as well, had a hard time sleeping last night because it got so cold. I was in the fetal position all night long, just trying to sleep. It was so hard. Waking up this morning, there was like frost all over the tops of our tent. Right back there over, are you over this way, my right shoulder? Over there, somewhere back there. You can't miss it. It's the beautiful Mount Kilimanjaro.
You know, I came into the trip probably feeling in the best shape of my life. I've been training for triathlons, and so I felt physically like I should be able to handle this, but I gotta tell you, like, last night was rough. My body's starting to break down a bit. I just couldn't get warm last night, and the last thing you wanna do is, like, leave that tent. But my stomach started to go, and I gotta get up a couple times in the night to go sit on some freezing ass toilet out here. It's just not pleasant, you know? There's a lot of pain. It's hard. It's a struggle. It's not easy climbing this mountain. But you know, I guess there's always these moments, you know, you get up, you're sitting on this cold toilet, you're feeling sick, and you come out, and the most brilliant stars you've ever seen in your whole life, and the sliver of a crescent moon, and this amazing view of the face of Kilimanjaro, and just a panoramic view of clouds and ridges below. So, you know, kind of God telling me, you know, the pain and the suffering's worth it. Keep fighting, and I think we can still make it up there, but it's gonna be a struggle. The major thing that I had no idea about was the porters and the guides. Like, I have a deep and profound respect for them because they carry the bulk of the weight for everything in camping. These people have literally kept us alive, kept us on track, and are getting us to the summit. So these guys are tough, they're workhorses, and they are humble. They also are bringing up all the water for us to drink, they are bringing all the food, and they cook full meals for us. It's not like we're just getting, like, camp meals. This is full-on culinary delights we're seeing. And toilets, they have toilets. There's a guy that takes care of all that.
Today was unbelievable. I mean, every day we sort of feel like, you know, I can't really get better than what we just saw, but today, for me, took the cake. I mean, we were sort of doing rock climbing, scrambling. There's a few points where you're kind of the guides behind you, but if you slipped, you could be in trouble.
Really got this sense that one wrong move and you were over the edge. There was nowhere to go but over. This view is unbelievable because we're above a sea of clouds that seem to go on forever.
The best day ever. Every day I keep saying, this is so cool, this is so cool, this is the best ever, but today really is the best ever.
Alicia, how do you feel?
Good. This is the coolest thing I've ever done.
Champion!
Is this the summit?
No.
as I see a smile on a child's face, it's a little gesture, but it means you're welcome. Come to join in on what we're doing.
This guy
made it?
Yes.
He could work for the car company one day. Kids mean the world to me. And we want to set them down the right paths in life so they can grow up to become amazing citizens of their communities and do good things. And it starts at a young age like this, like with schooling, with them being taught right from wrong. And that's what seems to be going on in this community right here. How important the kids are in their community, because they're the future of this community. Rhiannon, she is an incredible, incredible leader that we have. She's in control, she's funny, she's organized, she's skilled, and I'm really fortunate and glad that she's the leader of our team, and she's going to get us to that summit tomorrow morning.
I first came to Kili in 2010 as my first trip with Charity Challenge, and I now live here in Tanzania. My job on the trip is really to keep the team safe, to make sure they have everything they need, and obviously to make sure everybody gets to the top.
Obviously on Kili the main problem is altitude. A lot of people are taking prophylactic medicine to prevent problems. We're currently at 4,200 metres and by this stage most people are vomiting, they have headaches, they're quite unwell, but everyone is doing fantastically well.
Kilimanjaro is not easy, and so it's so far out of people's comfort zones. That's the beauty of it. That's a huge privilege to work with and to watch people grow. Yesterday was probably the biggest day other than summit, and they cruised. We got to 4,600 metres and everybody was in great shape. Summit night on Kili is in a whole different league to what we've done so far. For many, and probably most, will be about to undertake the hardest night of their lives. Anything between 12 and 14 hours round trip to the high camp, through the dark, through the cold, all the way up to 5,895 meters.
Where we are going, which is Barafu, or the base camp. 6 o'clock, we're going to wake up, so Felix will do the same day every day he's doing. And then 7 o'clock, we have a breakfast here. And then 7:45, we'll go start to go up. Get up. I don't want to get in my cocoon. I'm so cold. Face the mountain, because today is going to be the day, my friend, where we leave.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
We're going to head out.
Tonight at midnight. We reach the summit.
That's right.
But that's tonight. Can't we just sleep in a little longer? It's so cold out there.
The mountain waits for no one, including you.
Oh.
Host of entertainment tonight.
Well, there's Felix.
I'm here.
Yay, Felix.
Good morning.
Good morning. Yeah, come on in, Felix.
Yeah.
It's too cold in here.
Yeah, not too cold.
Not too cold.
A little cold.
See, Felix brings us our coffee in the morning.
Oh, is that you?
Asante-san. And we're going to do our little, 4-hour climb?
Yeah.
Up to the next level to prepare us for the summit ascent tonight at midnight. And then by this time, tomorrow morning, we're going to be on top of the world.
You're forced to get to know people extremely fast. Like, you have to rely on these people. You have to find out what they're like. It's easy to get on someone's nerve. So you kind of learn, you know, what are the boundaries? What are the limits you can?
So I was just sitting up on that rock.
Yeah.
You know, just staring at
deep
the
thoughts,
mountain.
Right?
Yeah, deep thoughts. You know, what's cool is I like the people underneath, you know?
So
like,
true.
Really
so
nice, true. Really great, and been getting some sunscreen in my eye here.
I know, you're crying? Come on, man.
Like, sunscreen,
crying,
man.
Crying.
I'm sharing it to you. But give me a hug, man.
Oh, man, come on.
Hug it out.
Hey, can I do one quick blessing for us before we go up?
Yeah.
Dear God, we thank you for bringing us this far. We thank you that we're all together still as a team. You brought us to this point. We'll accept whatever comes our way. We'll walk with you. But God willing, we also just pray that we'll all make it to the top. And walk with us today. Walk with our guides, walk with our leaders, walk with each of us. Amen.
Amen.
Hot.
we went up over a big ridge and down into this valley, and it was like moonscape or Mars or something.
Summit. Can't wait.
That was a tough hike today up to Barafu. I think 700 meters gain. It was not easy. It was hard. And I'm having some nerves about tonight and taking off at midnight.
So we just arrived at base camp. I am purely and utterly exhausted. There was times I felt like I was just going to collapse on the trail. But I'm also very stubborn, so I kept one foot after another. And this is something to see up here, like very, very rugged terrain. And we're on the side of a mountain. Like when we sleep, we're sleeping on an angle.
My thing.
Okay, team. You were so incredible then that you just beat the crew. You may have noticed behind you that there's a whole lot of men working as hard and as fast as they possibly can to set up your tents.
We've just arrived at Barafu camp and we've arrived ahead of schedule. Everyone has done amazingly well. And again, another great day. The only injury today was me. I fell over and I've got a big egg on my leg, which I'm not going to show you because my legs are hairy. And I also burned my fingers. So far, the only injuries are the doctor.
So I think the big thing now is eat as much food as we can, get as much rest as we can, because we've got a big mountain to climb tonight.
I just had like a little sobbing fit in the tent. You know, I did think I'd make it this far because I didn't know what I was getting into. I kind of went in really ignorant and blind. Now knowing what I've gotten into, I think I'm amazed. So I am more surprised than anything that I'm sitting here getting ready to summit tonight. And I think of all the people that have been behind me to do this and that supported this because of the World Vision projects, that is going to make the huge difference going up there. I think the ride up here was the first experience. It was unbelievable how far we came up to 6,000 feet to get to this health clinic, because I guess it services 4,000 different people, different tribes from around the area. It's unbelievable where they would have had to go on 70 kilometers from here to get any kind of medical attention. So to come and to see the doctors that are on staff and that they've gone to school, got an education and come to give back, that's pretty amazing. And see a child here with her mother and she walks out smiling because she's been given medical service and attention. It's pretty incredible to be able to see that.
This is the first time ever in my life that I've done anything like this physically demanding. I thought I could do it, you know, I thought I could do it if my health held up and, you know, the knees held up, my ankles, you know, this is an old body you're looking at right here, you know, the wear and tear over the years. The team's been pumping me up, the mountain's been pumping me up, and now we're right here. There's so much involved with something like this, and I'm just honored to be part of it. I really am. I'm glad I'm here.
I'm feeling exhausted, like physically, emotionally too. Like, this has been really rough just all around. Like, it wears you down. I've never come close to doing anything like this in my life. I'm scared because we're doing this at night. Like, we're gonna be doing this long, long trek, 7 hours from midnight to 7 a.m. And that's when we'll get to the summit.
I wanted to quickly say a few words to everybody. It's really important to note that as we go up, draw on whatever is going to get you to the next step, whether it's the kids that you saw, whether it's people up above or people on the ground, whatever it is, draw on that, because that's going to get you to the top. We're going to do it. We're going to do it as a team. I'm probably going to be the slowest, but that's okay. And you guys might hear me crying at the very end of it. It's such a privilege to be able to walk in the same line as everybody. So thank you all from the bottom of my heart. Thank you guys so much. I really appreciate it. Right then, team. Most of you didn't know each other. Most of you had never done anything, well, all of you, I think, had never done anything quite like this before. Didn't know what to expect, and as I say, you were the top 10% before you even set foot on this mountain. So to be sat here now, in the shape that you're in, preparing for the summit, is a huge, huge achievement. Whatever happens tonight, wherever we go from here, just, you should feel immensely, immensely proud of yourselves. I'm very, very proud of where you're all at.
Are you scared?
I'm petrified. Being naive a little bit to this it's probably a plus for sure, but I think also at a certain point it just becomes mental, and you have to be able to say, you know, there's a lot of people in the world who go through far, far harder things on a daily basis. This is just a week of my life.
I'm feeling quite positive about tonight. I've got some nerves, understandably. This is the first time I've done it too. But really, after listening to Rhiannon, Daniel, all the guides, we really are a strong group, and all the other doctors I've spoken to have been up here usually have a lot more problems by this stage. So I'm feeling positive.
I think nerves have started to set in a little bit. You're humbled by how big this mountain is. I think the next step is really the challenge, though. It's kind of where we need to dig deep and find out what we're made of.
But people do die on this climb, not like a high percentage, but it does happen. And you're climbing at night with headlamps, you know, higher than I've ever been. It's been a lot of work just to get to this point, and the biggest step is the one that comes next.
Physically, I'm starting to feel a bit run down. 6 full days of hiking is starting to take its toll on my body. Emotionally, I'm scared, you know, and I'm scared about variables that I actually have absolutely no control over. I don't know what it's going to be like to climb in the cold, and I don't know what the altitude's going to do to me. Sorry.
At 11 o'clock, you will be woken. You cannot afford to miss that wake-up call. So it is a case of getting up, getting your stuff together, putting on the extra layers that you need to put on. We walk out of here at midnight, okay?
We just heard the cock crow. Felix, it's showtime. It's time to climb to the top of the mountain. I'm so excited. I didn't get my sleep at all. Maybe 15 minutes. But I just kept dreaming of getting to this. I was like a kid on Christmas Eve.
Individually, we'd never make it to the top. But as a team, we're going to get to the top, all of us, together.
Yeah, let's do this.
Tonight, once we walk out of here at midnight, okay, you put one foot in front of the other, you look after each other, and we start as a team, we climb as a team, we finish as a team.
We left in the dark to head up 7 hours. Like, I've never done anything in rocks and hiking in the pitch black with a headlamp, and you don't know where your footing is, and what we were told to do is rely on the person in front of you and the person behind you. You're responsible for them.
All these feelings are and emotions are running through. You're cold, you're hungry, you're exhausted.
There will be points tonight where some of you will think, screw this, what the hell am I doing here? I don't want to go. Dig deep.
I was in the red zone for a lot of points during this trip, and there was numerous times that I just wanted to say, that's it, I'm done.
The unicorn is tired.
I'm tired.
Weary.
Breaking out the peanut M&Ms for some energy, you know?
3 minutes, guys!
It was scary. Looks to the right, looking over a cliff, you look to the left, and it's pure darkness because if you took one wrong step.
We climbed and we climbed, and people were starting to fight and struggle with internally on how they were going to get there. You could see the fear in some people's eyes and know that, are we going to get there? Are we going to not make it?
A couple people in the group got hit by altitude and were really fighting to get up to the top.
I was just gassed. I didn't have anything left in me. The whole exhaustion and fatigue really hit me, and I just started crying. Just talking with Rhiannon, and then she was asking me, you know, are you feeling sick? Anything with the altitude? And I said, well, it has nothing to do with that. I'm just really tired, and I really don't think I can make it up there. And she says, well, you have no reason that you can't summit this, and you're going to do this.
All you could see is trailing up this hill was other lights of other people summiting Kilimanjaro or heading up there. And along the way, the most disturbing thing is the people that didn't make it. I think that, you know, were sick by the side, that had to be pulled off, that people were running them down the hill, that, you know, they couldn't do it.
6 or 7 hours alone in your own mind is, it can be frightening, but it can also be amazing. At a certain point, it becomes all mental. You have to put one foot in front of the other and just trust yourself.
So you heard the expression before, the night is darkest just before the dawn, but that felt real. The last bit before the summit was this crazy incline with switchback, 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 and just every step was a struggle. But then just as you're, you know, felt like some people weren't going to make it and we weren't going to make it to the top, you could just see this glimmer of light on the horizon behind one of the faces of the mountain. And then as we get to the top, the sun peaks up over, you know, just at that time, and you could see the landscape of Africa just kind of unfolding out before you.
And it was really great just hearing the comments from the others down the line, like, you're doing great, Arian, keep it up, keep doing what you're doing. That really lifted me up. So knowing that the whole team was behind me, I was like, I can't let them down, gotta keep going, even if it's just 1 inch at a time.
Stand up, wait now.
I feel like my legs are about to fall off. Oh. Big smiles.
You get to see her.
I honestly don't think I would have ever made it on my own, because I thought it so many times that I would just quit, because it's hard. It was the hardest thing I've ever done in my life.
Oh, congrats. You did it.
You did so well.
Dark, that was awesome.
You did awesome.
Guys, how does it feel? Okay. Just sit down somewhere.
Awesome. We had the determination of a whole team behind us, and we had the guidance of these amazing leaders showing us the way.
We finally got to that ridge at the top by the crater. I just fell on my knees. I'm like, I couldn't believe we actually got there.
Congratulations!
Nice job.
Cousins,
oh, great job. Yeah, it's amazing. What a team effort. Uh-huh. I'm so glad everybody got here together and we stayed together as a team. Spectacular.
I just couldn't believe it. Like, I had to take a few moments and just like clear my head and realize that we did it. We got up there.
Thank God we're here.
You're a killer, huh? Yeah.
Okay, we'll do. Oh, thank you. Okay. Yay!
We're just catching on.
We had more in us than we ever even knew.
I'm glad that's at least that part's over with.
It's a lot more challenging than I expected. I had nausea almost throughout.
I think I was just feeling every emotion. I'm just so happy. Sorry.
I'm feeling very happy because everybody's good. We are just keeping going to Uhuru. That's why I'm happy for that.
Couldn't have done it
without
you.
Yeah, we are right here at Stella Point, very high.
Yeah.
Right straight onto the rim. Looking forward to have a cup of tea to warm up the body with the biscuits. And then after 45 minutes, walking a long way.
Probably the hardest part was once you got up there, you realize there's now another 45 minutes to get to the summit of Kilimanjaro.
However, it's like somebody put lead in your friggin' boots. It's unbelievable because you're so high by that point. It's hard graft, okay?
There's this beautiful, beautiful view of the world below because you're so high. You know, you're on top of the clouds. You can see other mountaintops.
There's just that physical exhaustion, and yet you know that the time is ticking. It was really just pulling from those places within that you didn't know you had.
As soon as I get to the summit, I'm thinking, wow, we have done it. Like, oh my God, we're here. And you see the signs and you're like, we're really here. We made it. The entire team made it.
I had the support of the team, like pushing me on, and we all encouraged each other and found ways to support each other, and we all got up there. It was empowering.
I'm just so proud of this team, and everything that's happened in the last 7 days was an incredible experience.
There was a bigger purpose, you know? There was something greater that we were doing this for.
One of the most amazing experiences of my life, top of the world, roof of Africa, Kili for kids.
Just amazing. It was a bit emotional. Everyone really happy. Everyone there together.
I'm told that I'm the first unicorn on Mount Kilimanjaro. All the other hikers coming up there were all like, what the heck is going on? Then they wanted pictures.
Most teams have huge camaraderie. I would say this team had it in leaps and bounds to have that full 100% belief and faith. And I had it in them and they had it in themselves.
It was an exciting, exhilarating, exhausting experience. We put our faith in each other and got all the way up to 20,000 feet.
Kili climb for kids!
It is a journey, right? It's about the people and the things that you're learning about yourself and other people along the way.
And so I think for me, I'm walking away from this as a different person than I came into it.
Action.
Yes, my name is Felix. I'm climbing mountain Kilimanjaro. I'm gonna to sing song with Hakuna Matata from Kilimanjaro. Okay, Jambo, Jambo Bwana, habari gani, uzuri sana, wageni, mwakaribishwa Kilimanjaro, Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna matata.
Tukaenda Shirawani.
Hakuna matata.
Tukafika Shiratu.
Hakuna matata.
Tulienda Baranko.
Hakuna matata.
Tukafika Karanga.
Hakuna matata.
Tulifika Barafu.
Hakuna matata.
Leo Meleniamu.
Hakuna matata.
Tunatabo Ageti.
Hakuna matata. Kilimanjaro.